Hi, I'm Robert Ranieri, the artist, and you may be familiar with my work somewhat by now. Now, these are two works on wood panel, and they're of a subject matter that kind of grew up as I developed. I have a series of them, and I have three from last year, and the one on the left is from last year. The one on the right is of 2020, and you can see that there's plenty of differentiation, variety in the formation. And one of the things I have, mentioned in terms of my familiarity with architecture, particularly classical architecture, is that there's a simple geometric forms which are engaged as an important device or housing for the majority of internal structures that you see in architectural works. And of course, since I'm also a landscape architect, I tend to want to put the architecture surrounded by quasi landscape aspects. And in this case, the two works here have what I would call gateways. So it's a gateway through something, through into a building, or leaving the area in front of a city and going inside. So there's an opening and a closing of the works. And here, this is again from last year. You can see there's a dominance of certain forms. This you may recognize when you see my work on my website, is a kind of ellipsis. It comes from the idea that I have a circle above and a circle below, but they've been skewered or tweaked. So I have this flexed form, which I see as being both coming forward and going backward. And it has been understood that cool forms or cool colors will retreat while warm colors will come forward. And that's one of the optics that the artist can deal with and take advantage of. And as you can see, also, there's a notion of scale. So down here, we have a kind of miniaturized architectural structure, which can be seen rather quickly because the light and dark areas and the specificity of the drawing and the graphic structuring. But also you have then a competition. Obviously, there's a dramatic form here, which was one of the earliest things that I was after, kind of a squaring of the form within which I have trapped or enclosed the brightest color overall on the entire painting, which is that kind of muted yellow with kind of horizontal striations, perhaps indicating a light source behind this dark structure, again, which is trimmed and formed, geometrically to be quite blunt and squared as against, again, this elliptical form and other curves that you see, which now, in this case, you have an arcing at the top and then two other arcs which are kind of echoing that, and they give you a kind of stepping stone of progressions back into the steps, this being the furthest away. But then there's also the return of the curves, which you see drawn out here very carefully. And it has to be understood that by shaping and having diminished thickness of the line, thickening out and curving toward us, there is intention that this lower form will be advancing forward. Not like train tracks, but you see it's disappearing to a dot on the horizon line. There's still a great feel of the flatness this shows, but also, again, this opportunity suggests that it can advance toward us. So there's a sense that we can progress into the space. And in opposition to that, contained within this blue ellipsis, there are shadowy forms which are somewhat in the distance, so that you get this collision or, say, contest between what is further away and what is closer. And again, these are competitors in that kind of dichotomy or competition. And so, there are other devices which would help, bring it forward more. And you can see now this black line is deliberately shaped just enough to go over top of this yellow form, muted yellow, so that it will, pull that pink forward, and the pink is the housing for the blue. So there's, again, there's this kind of duality that's at play. And on the white, the painting on the right, which is rather recent, there's again a play of openings and closures like a city gate. And in competition, we have this opening here is one of the most principal ones that becomes quite dramatic. Though small, it has contained within itself that collision or that competition between its location, say, closer to the viewer or further away. And then once you understand that that's one of my major concerns and, say, pleasures, is to have this competition take place. Now, for example, this structure is rather large. It's a warm red, and it is pressing forward and made sure that it does so when you look at this large white shape, which is, of course, very central in the organization, the composition. But within that, you see very shadowy horizontal darks, painted somewhat like my works on paper, where I use dark strokes of black, and then they're veiled by a scrim, a veiling of the white here, done with a large brush, swept over that, so that there's this, problem or for the viewer to identify where this may be located relative to the other larger forms. Again, this vertical construct against this larger form. And this red form here also is a kind of housing or a support for some very small, elements, a kind of a graphic twerking of the black here, and then this half blue circle, which is shown to be narrow and then widening out as though it's torqued in space, and it's propelled forward because of how it's overlapping other forms there. And because of the red having a possibility of coming forward, it is also propelled forward. And then, of course, the organization of the dark forms, whether it's rock forms, related somewhat to my constructions outside in terms of landscape architecture, and then also a stacking, almost like a stair-like development. Actually, if you take an oblique, you can actually get across here and go up that way. So there's a secret geometry of that flexed directional taking place, and that kind of lateral and horizontal emphasis is occurring in a number of situations as I develop it. And so you can go like stepping stones on a stream, you can bounce the eye up in that way obliquely. And again, what's happening on a horizontal section if you have a horizontal line through here, or the vertical or the horizontal working, horizontal versus the working vertical emphasis. And on that vertical emphasis, we have the kind of a little subtle challenge that I have for the viewer. There is a small arcing form here, and that's housed by this red, which is very cleanly articulated by a very thin black line, and that's in competition with some of the forms here. Now, this see-through form and this slot, this gap in the wall or in the design, is housing this, which may be seen to be the furthest away. So it's a competition between this being located in this high positioned, rectangle, and then how does that relate in terms of being nearer to the viewer or further away? And we have that kind of competition. You have a faint one here. So on that oblique, you have another opportunity to see if it's divulging one particular one momentarily the advantage of being forward or further away. And that kind of thing happens again in my work. And of course, in this kind of notation, marking, quasi-architectural definitions, and you have another tone up here, which is an echo perhaps of that. So again, that kind of triangulation or oblique structuring. And then with this here, you have a repeat of that form in a larger shape of the squared rectilinear form, which is, again, pulls the eye up. They're getting a kind of vertical emphasis here amidst all the other dichotomies that take place. And of course, what is brighter, you have, of course, a bright white, but this yellow is certainly a pretty bright use. There's a similar kind of yellow over here, and of course the muted ones. So, and certain colors can be kept up one sleeve and used, say, with limited intention, but making it very important to know how it is positioned relative to your entire work. And attention, say, the rock formations or muted landscape enclosure there. So it's a composite of structure and also a play on the spatial relationships. And you'll see more on my website and others that are coming into pass soon enough. So I thank you. Talk to you next time.